Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to perform selection in Syncfusion Angular TrigGrid. In this video, I will show you the selection types, selection modes, cell selection modes, uncheckbox selection with its modes, and finally selection using APIs. I am using the sample application used in the Getting Started video, which was configured with all the necessary TrigGrid modules and data configured to it. You can also watch my Getting Started video, which I have shared in the YouTube card. First, let me show you the two selection types. One is single selection, which is the default selection type, and the other is multiple selection. I will show you how to configure selection types in the sample. Open the appcomponent.ts file and import selection settings model from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular TrigGrid. In the appcomponent class, declare a variable named selection options of type selection settings model. In the ng-onInit method, assign the value for the selection options object with the type single. Let me change the page size to 13 to show more rows in the TrigGrid. Open the appcomponent.html file and assign the value for the TrigGrid property selection settings with the selection options object. Now run the sample. I can now select a single row in the TrigGrid. In the appcomponent.ts file, change a selection options type to multiple and save the file. Now I can select multiple rows by pressing the Ctrl key and clicking the mouse. Also, I can select contiguous rows by selecting one row, holding the Shift key and clicking the last row to be selected. Now, I will move to the second part of the video about selection modes. TrigGrid supports three selection modes: row, cell, and both. The row value is the default selection mode, hence we can select the row without setting the mode property. Let me change this to cell selection. Open the appcomponent.ts file and in the selection options object, add another property named mode and assign the value cell to it. Now save the file. In the browser, you can see the selection based on cells. Cell selection requires the selection settings mode to be cell or both. And in this mode, also type can be either single or multiple. Now change the mode to both. I can select both rows and cells. Next, I will move to the third part of the video about setting cell selection modes in the TrigGrid. TrigGrid supports three types of cell selection modes: flow, box, box with border. To set a selection mode in TrigGrid, in the selection options object, add the property cell selection mode and assign the value flow. Flow is the default cell selection type. Let me change the mode to cell so that we can see the selection based on cells. Save the file. Now select the cells using mouse and shift key. You can see the entire row in between the selected range of cells got selected. Now change the property value to box and save the file. Select the cells using mouse and shift key, but now you can see the selection behaves like a box selecting in between cells in the selected range. Change the property cell selection mode value to box with border and save the file. Select the cells using mouse and shift key. You can see the selection behaves like a box selecting in between cells in the selected range with a border. Note that cell selection requires the selection setting mode to be cell or both, and type should be multiple. Let me move on to the fourth part of the video about checkbox selection and its modes. Checkbox selection provides an option to select multiple TrigGrid records with the help of checkboxes in each row. To enable checkbox in the TrigGrid, I will open the appcomponent.html file and add a checkbox column using the columns directive. Since a new column will be added, I am changing the tree column index value to 2 To show the expand and collapse options in the task name column, save the file, and you can see the triggered with a checkbox column. I can perform multiple selection in this mode by clicking the desired rows. To select a range of rows, press and hold the Shift key and click the in-between rows. By default, selection is allowed by clicking a triggered row or checkbox in that row. To allow selection only through checkboxes, you can set the selection settings checkbox only property to true. Save the file, and you can select the row only by clicking on the checkbox. Clicking on other cells won't allow you to select the rows. Checkbox selection mode has two types, default and reset on row click. Default is the predefined value for the checkbox mode. You can see this behavior when I select the checkboxes, which selects the rows one by one. Let me change the checkbox mode to reset on row click. I will click row by row. Now you can see that when I select any second row, it will reset the previously selected rows checked state. Selection can be persisted on all the operations by setting the selection settings persist selection property to true. For persisting selection in the tree grid, any one of the columns should be defined as a primary key using the columns is primary key property. So here I am setting the task ID as the primary key column. Save the file. Select the row and do any action like sorting. You can see that selection is persisted even after grid actions. Now I will move on to the fifth and final part of the video about selection using APIs. You may need to select cells or rows on demand while running your application without using a keyboard or mouse. In such situations, you can use these APIs to select cells or rows in the tree grid. Let's see how to select a cell. In the appcomponent.html file, add a button control using the EJS button tag, add the content as API and bind a click event named onClicked so that while clicking on this button, we can perform selection at runtime. In the TreeGrid component, add a selector named TreeGrid. To access this TreeGrid object in the appcomponent.ts file, import the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular button package using the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 Angular buttons. Open the appmodule.ts file. Import the button module from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular buttons and add it to the imports array. In the appcomponent.ts file, using the viewchild decorator, I will create an instance of TreeGrid by defining its type as TreeGrid component. Import the viewchild from Angular core and TreeGrid component from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular TreeGrid. Implement the onClicked method. And to select a cell, call the TreeGrid's SelectCell method and pass the row index and cell index as objects. Now save the file and click the API button. You can see the specified row and cell index has been selected in the TreeGrid. As I explained earlier, to perform cell selection, you need to specify the mode either cell or both. To select a row, call the TreeGrid's SelectRow method and pass the row index 3. Save the code. Click the API button and you can see the fourth TreeGrid row in the selected state. You can also select multiple rows by creating an array of row indexes and passing it to the TreeGrid's SelectRows method. I am commenting out the other code and saving the file. Click the API button. You can see the row indexes specified in the array were selected in the TreeGrid. Also, you can use the select checkboxes method to select rows when checkboxes are enabled in the TreeGrid. This code won't work if checkboxes were not enabled. To clear the selections from the tree grid, use the clear selection method. I am saving the file. Let me select few rows. Clicking on the API button clears the selection. You can also get the selected record details using APIs. For more information about tree grid APIs, please refer to our online documentation link provided in the below description. Finally, let me summarize the main points. I have explained the steps to configure the selection types and modes. I have explained the cell selection modes and checkbox selection and its modes. I have also explained how to perform selection using APIs. You can download this featured sample from the link provided in the below description. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications for our new videos. Thanks for watching.